National Socialist Movement is the front lines in this struggle against legal immigration. We're on the front lines in Arizona, in California, in Texas, all over the American Southwest.
Society as a whole is undergoing big demographic change. White people, those that deem themselves white people, are in the process of becoming a minority and a nation of minorities. They won't be able to enforce through democratic measures the white privileges of the past. And they're seeking to maintain those privileges and that position in our society through other means. My name is Leonard Zeskind. I'm president of the Institute for Research and Education on Human Rights. I have been actively organizing, researching, and writing about the problem of white nationalism for more than 30 years.
The National Socialist Movement is the front line in this struggle against...
I believe that what I call the white nationalist movement is what some people refer to as the face of hate. The white nationalist movement is a set of organizations and individuals who are dedicated to the proposition that what they call white people should have a homeland of their own and run a white nationalist state.
And why should we be concerned about these? If some of them maybe are dwindling or there's infighting going on, they're in disarray, some of their leaders are dead, why do we need to pay attention?
Well, it's like cancer. There's no small case of cancer. Every cancer is a big problem. So some of the cancers get violent, like Glenn Miller did. Glenn Miller was a long-term violence-in-the-making character. He's been active since the 70s on National Socialist issues and organizations. But this shooting took place at the end of that career, not at the beginning. But there are others who you have to worry about who were promulgating the set of ideas to break up the United States, to break it into a white set of white republics or white-only territories. There are ways to stop white nationalist organizations. When the organizations are responsible for violence, they can be sued and broken up. Some organizations have done that. Other cases, you expose them to the broader light of day, and they've been hiding their real agenda, and it exposes them and makes them less powerful. But there is no situation where letting them sit is a good situation. Every time you see them, you have to stand up and say no. You have to have a moral voice on this issue. Without a moral voice, you don't have a voice. It's a question of good and evil, a question of good and bad. It's a question of the way we want to live versus the way we don't want to live. And religious leaders of all types, as well as people who don't have religions, who are secular or atheists or so forth, they have to stand up and take moral positions on this.